I'm on the California Air Resources Board. I'm the physician member. And we are trying to initiate several policy efforts to improve the air quality in California, in part to protect kids with asthma. And so I want to share with you some of those efforts. We're trying to reduce diesel emissions by asking bus and truck owners to either retrofit their older engines or buy new engines for their vehicles. And where there's actually financial incentives for doing this that the voters of California have made available through a bond issue. And we're also asking owners of construction vehicles, diesel construction vehicles, to upgrade their engines either by retrofitting or buying new engines. And then a major effort is to try to decrease diesel emissions from surface goods movement. What do I mean by surface goods movement? Well, as most of you know, many of our household appliances are produced in Asia, and they come over in large container vessels and come to the ports in Los Angeles, Long Beach, and Oakland, where, you know, they dock, and they traditionally keep their diesel engines on while they're docked. So emissions are still coming out of the smokestacks. The cranes traditionally were diesel powered, and then the trucks and trains that the cranes are offloading the containers to were also diesel. And then these diesel trains and trucks transport the containers to distribution centers where the containers are broken down and the individual boxes are put on other trucks. So these distribution centers are basically truck farms where there are both the trucks and trains that, you know, brought the containers to the distribution centers, and then the large trucks that are carrying the appliances and boxes to your local big box store. So that's what the surface goods movement chain is all about, and there's diesel emissions related to this all along the chain. So we're trying to decrease diesel emissions at every point. We're trying to provide electric power for the ships that dock at our ports, trying to electrify the cranes, and then trying to encourage the purchase of cleaner diesel engines for the trucks and trains that the containers are offloaded to, and then of course the trucks that deliver excuse me, the boxes to the local retail stores. We're also trying to improve car emissions, and this slide is showing a electric battery vehicle that has much reduced emissions compared to even the cleanest gasoline car, and we're trying to push for a large percentage of the cars on the road in 2020 to be such advanced clean cars, and we're basically pushing the auto industry to produce these cars. California, as usual, is leading the nation in this effort. And then we're also trying to encourage smart growth. And smart growth means having people live near public transportation or actually where they work, so they don't even have to take public transportation and they can either walk or ride a bike. So that means decreased vehicle miles traveled, which means decreased air pollution and decreased greenhouse gas emissions, which are causing climate change. And California now has a rule, a law, that mandates that metropolitan planning organizations meet targets for decreased emissions of CO2. And basically this means planning where people live and work to be closer together and have higher density housing so that we don't have suburban sprawl. And finally, throughout the state, we're finding efforts to decrease the amount of wood smoke emissions. This is primarily a winter problem, unlike the smog of the summer. During winter, the mixing layer for pollution goes down because of colder air at a lower atmospheric level. So not only are people burning wood in the winter, there's also a less dilution of that wood smoke in the smaller mixing layer that occurs in the winter. And so there's been major efforts in the San Joaquin Valley, which has a lot of wood burning during the winter. And now you have to check before you burn, as this slide shows, to make sure that it's a day when it's okay to burn wood in your fireplace or in your stove. And we also have that in the Bay Area. The Bay Area Air Quality Management District has a Spare the Night effort, somewhat similar to their Spare the Air Day effort, so that on certain days when the mixing layer is predicted to be particularly small, they don't allow wood burning in fireplaces and stoves, and people actually get fined if they do in fact burn on those Spare the Night days.